Hey everyone, thanks for clicking the video. I wanted to make a quick video response on the Browns signing McKinley, defensive end, pass rusher, in free agency today. The contract, I believe, was 4.5 million, up to 6 million incentives, something around that. Yeah, it's interesting. He's notorious for being the guy that failed a few physicals. And he also had a Twitter mishap where he mentioned that he's joining this team. He's excited to play for them. And then he ended up copying that exact same message like not too long after for that new team that he ended up playing for, I think due to him failing the physical then, if I remember correctly. He's an interesting guy. I don't hate the pickup like some fans do. For that amount of money, it's worth a shot. He clearly has some upside. I know the Browns were trying to claim him last year, so from that standpoint, they clearly see something in him and there's some interest from the Browns front office perspective at least. What concerns me is I hope and or hope we should all hope and pray that he's not considered the number one option for defensive end opposite of Myles Garrett. I'm hoping that will occur either via trade or with the draft still going on in April. Clearly, with free agency now, I don't know if you would sign anyone else that would really be that much better than McKinley now. So it doesn't make sense that they'll just kind of like maybe sign, like, for example, Hassan Reddick and pair him with him as an addition. I just don't see that happening because I don't know if there's that skill set's that much better than McKinley's. So at that point, you might as well bank on trying to trade for some guy that maybe they have in mind, or try to draft somebody in the draft, hopefully an early round, first or second. And that too, and we cut Adrian Claiborne, so I guess this is in a way, hopefully a piece that replaces him. It's roughly around the same money. I think McKinley should, well, not should, but he probably will get a little bit more money for this year. So I guess that's okay from that standpoint. So it's not, it's a low risk, high reward contract, naturally, just based on the lower amount of money for that position. So from that standpoint, I don't really hate it. Hopefully, he doesn't have any character issues. I'm not really sure on that. Kind of seeing some stuff online that from Atlanta fans and all that might be the case, but that could just be them being, whiny and stuff. So hopefully, yeah, he has good character, honestly. I think that's important, and he'll fit in the culture that the Browns are trying to build. So as long as that's the case, then I think the production, I'm okay with him being a number three option on our defensive line or for our double edge on left and right. Like Myles Garrett to be number one, obviously. And then I think we still need that number two, whether that's again via the trade or draft. Nonetheless, though, it's an addition's an addition. I guess you could make the argument he could be upgrade over Adrian Claiborne, just with a little bit more upside than him. Adrian Claiborne probably has a higher floor, which is not saying much again, but nonetheless, worth a shot. But yeah, hopefully, like I said, in previous videos before, check out my last one. I hope we kind of add some second or maybe another additional corner in free agency still. All the names are starting to dry up. I still like Troy Hill from formerly the Los Angeles Rams. So hopefully we can pick someone like that up. People do think that we have all this cap space to still go crazy, and if you look at it, I think we're projected like 2024 now, which that'll get eaten up pretty quickly, especially if we end up extending some guys this offseason, potentially Nick Chubb, potentially like Wyatt Teller. There goes some money because I think that might take effect soon. I'm not really sure. I guess that would be one more year. But either way, there's a lot of money that we can't really, we need to have that space for, and we got to account for the draft as well. Taking account for some X amount of million just for to pay our draft picks. So not too much going on from the Browns standpoint, which I thought it's interesting. I thought they would be getting kind of like two top guys, like a John Johnson, like what we did, and then I thought a pass rusher, potentially a linebacker, although I highly doubt it, but I thought a cornerback. I thought like Griffin, for example, who went to the Jaguars, his contract's a little bit ridiculous, I think, for him. But somebody like that in that kind of level. But we'll see. Still early in everything. Again, I don't, free agency is not even like technically a thing because it's just the legal tampering period, which is, as we all know, that's BS. But hopefully the Browns kind of have some idea in mind to hopefully add some more additional help throughout the defensive line. We still need a nose tackle. With Sheldon Richardson, I know we have Andrew Billings who didn't play last year, but I don't know if he's with his contract. I don't know if he was meant to be the starting guy. Hopefully, a depth piece. So if we could get someone along the line too, I think that'd be great. Again, we still have plenty of time. Offseason's just starting, so I'm not too concerned about that, but nonetheless, those are holes we need to fill. But yeah, that's kind of just quick thoughts on McKinley signing. I guess overall, we'll take it. Not too thrilled, not too upset about it either. It's just as long as we don't assume, or as long as the Browns aren't moving forward with him being kind of that number one guy opposite of Miles, I think we'll be okay with it. But yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. Please like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later.